Hello friends, welcome back to our channel. So in this video, we are going to discuss some important questions from the topic directions, which comes under the reasoning section. So these questions are important for your RBI Grade B prelim examination and also for SEBI Grade A and NABARD examination. So friends, if you like this video, then do subscribe to our channel. So let us see the first question. One evening, Avinash and Abhinav are talking to each other while sitting at either ends of seesaw facing each other. Avinash observed that his shadow is falling to his left. Which direction is Abhinav facing? So let me draw the diagram. So let's suppose this is Avinash and this is Abhinav. So this is the right of Avinash and this is the left of Avinash. So the question is saying that shadow is formed to the left of Avinash. And also both Avinash and Abhinav, they are facing each other. So you have to tell which direction is Abhinav facing. So we all know that sun, it rises in the east and sets in the west, which means in the morning, sun is in the eastern direction, but in the evening, sun is in the western direction. So in the question, the time is of evening, which means sun is in the west, so shadow, it will be formed in the direction opposite to west, east direction, which means that this is the east direction because shadow is formed here. So the left of Avinash is the east direction. So now you can easily tell me that in which direction Avinash is facing. So Avinash is facing south and Abhinav is facing north. Why? Because if you look at this direction diagram, this is north, south, east and west. So for a person facing south, east direction lies in the left. So Avinash is facing south and Abhinav is facing north. So the correct option is option A, north. Now let's move to the next question. Question 2. A clock is so placed that at 9 a.m. the minute hand points toward northeast. So if I draw a clock, this is 12, 3, 6, 9. So they are saying at 9 a.m. So at 9 a.m. this will be the hour end and this will be the minute end. So at 9 a.m. the minute hand, it is pointing towards northeast. So this is northeast. Now you can work out the other directions. So let me draw. So if this is northeast, this will be north, this will be east, and this is east, so this is west. And if this is north, this will be south, so this will be northwest. This will be southeast and this will be southwest. So we have got all the directions. So now the question is asking you, which direction does the hour end point at 3 p.m. So first of all, we need to plot 3 p.m. So at 3 p.m. the hour end will be here, right? So the hour end will be here and the minute hand will be at 12 only. So at 3 p.m. the hour end, it is pointing towards southeast. So the hour end is pointing towards southeast. So the correct option is option D, southeast. Now moving on to the next question. The question says, my office is to the east of my house. So let's say this is my house and the question is saying my office is to the east of my house. So let's say this is office. So office is in the east direction. And for your reference, you can always draw the direction graph: north, south, east, west, northeast, southwest, southeast, and northwest. So for your reference, you can always draw this. So my office is to the east of my house. Next, my sister's office is to the southeast of my office. So southeast is this direction. So my sister's office is to the southeast of my office. So let's say my sister's office is somewhat here, right? So this is sister office. Next, the question is saying a park is to the south of my office. So a park is to the south of my office. So to the south of my office, there is a park. Next, the question is saying in which direction is my house located with respect to the park. So you have to tell the direction of the house with respect to the park. So if you look at this, so the house is northwest to the park. So you can see this is the northwest direction from the graph. So the house is located northwest to the park. right? So here you have to be very careful. They are asking the location of house with respect to park. If the question would have asked you the location of park with respect to house, then your answer would have been different. Then the answer would have been southeast. But since they have asked the location of house with respect to park, so the answer is northwest. So the correct option is option C, northwest. Now let's move to the next question, question 5. A person is facing west. So let's draw the direction diagram. So this is north, south, east, west. This is northeast. This is southeast. This is southwest. And this is northwest. So now the question is saying the person is facing west. So this is the person, he is facing west. Next, the question says he turns 60 degrees in the clockwise direction. So the person moves 60 degrees in the clockwise direction. So the person is somewhere here. So now the person is facing northwest. This is 60. Next, the question says the person turns another 180 degrees in the same direction. So the person further turns clockwise 180 degrees. So this is the remaining 30 degrees because there are 90 degrees in a single quadrant. So this is 30, this is 90. So 90, 30 makes 120. So there is 60 still remaining. So this is 60. So the person has moved 180 degree. So now you can see the person is facing southeast. So now the person is facing southeast. Further, the question is saying that the person turns 270 degree in the anti-clockwise direction. So now you have to go in the reverse direction, 270 degree. So this is 60, then 90. So 60, 90, 150. Then again 90, so it becomes 240. So 30 degrees remaining. So this is 30. So now you can see that the person is facing southwest direction, right? So the correct option is option C, southwest direction. So question 6, it says point B is 5 meter to the east of point A. So let's suppose this is point A. So point B is 5 meter to the east of point A. Then point C is 3 meter to the south of point B. So let it be point C and it is 3 meter to the south of point B. Then point D is 4 meter to the west of point C. So this is point D and it is 4 meter to the west of C. Next, point D is 7 meter to the south of point E. So if point D is 7 meter to the south of point E, it means point E is 7 meter to the north of point D. So this whole DE, it is 7 meter. So you can break it into 3 and 4 because this is a rectangle. So opposite sides will be equal. So you can see AB is 5 meter. So we can divide this AB into 1 and 4 because this is a rectangle. Now next, point F is 1 meter to the west of point E. So this is point F. Next, point G is 1 meter to the south of point F. So this is point G. And it is 1 meter to the south of F. Next, if point H is 1 meter to the east of point A. So this point of intersection, it is H. So H is 1 meter to the east of point A. Now the question is asking you, what is the distance between H and C? So the distance between H and C, the diagonal of the rectangle. So now you can easily find out this length of HC with the help of Pythagoras theorem. So this is 3, this is 4. So applying Pythagoras theorem, HC will be under root of 3 square plus 4 square, which is under root of 25. So HC will be 5 meter. The correct option is option B, 5 meter. Now moving on to the next question, question 7. One evening, Raja started to walk towards the sun. So you know, in the evening, the sun is in the west direction. So if Raja is walking towards the sun, it means Raja is walking in the west direction. So this is the starting point of Raja. So Raja is walking in the west direction. So after walking a while, he turned to his right. So now he turns to the right and again to his right and again he turns to the right. Then the question says after walking a while, he again turned right. So now he again turned right. So the question is saying in which direction is he facing? So if you see the direction figure diagram, this is north, south, east and west. So initially he went towards west, towards the sun. then he went towards the north, then he went towards east, and finally he was walking towards south. So the question is asking in which direction is he facing. So finally he is facing south. So the correct option is option A, south. Moving on to the next question. There are four arrows pointing towards the four primary directions: east, west, north and south. For every hour, the arrows interchange with the next arrow in clockwise direction. So which means if this is our directions north, south, east and west, so they are saying every hour the arrows interchange with the next arrow in clockwise direction. So this is your clockwise direction. So every fourth hour the arrows, they will come back to their original position. So every fourth hour arrows will come back to their original position, right? Now they are asking after the 67th hour, in which direction does the arrow which was primarily pointing towards the north is pointing now. So see, if you look at 67 and divided by 4, so you will get 3 as a remainder, which means that an arrow pointing northwards, it will become east in the 65th hour, it will become south in the 66th hour, and it will become west in the 67th hour, because the direction is clockwise. So the correct option is option B, west. And we see the 68th hour, which is divisible by 4, so it is divisible by 4. So in the 68th hour, the arrow will come back towards north, right? So we are being asked 67, so the correct option is option B, west. Now next question, question 10, the Suvarna Rekha river flows from west to east. So the river is flowing from west to east. So these are our directions: east, west, north and south. So the river is flowing from west to east and on the way turns left. So then it turns left and goes in a quarter circle. So at this point the river moves in a quarter circle, 1/4 of a circle, right, around a Shiv temple, and then turns left in a right angle. So now you can see the river is facing this side. So it turns left in right angle, which means it turns upwards. So this is 90 degree, so it turns upwards. So the question is asking you in which direction is the river finally flowing. So you can easily tell now that the river is flowing now in north direction. So the correct option is option A, north. Now next, question 11, in a country XYZ, west means north, north means south, south means east, and east means west. It means that in the country XYZ, north direction, it is being called west. So this is the original direction and this is the name given in the XYZ country. So north direction, it is called west, south direction, it is called north, east direction, it is called south, and west direction, it is called east. So you have to understand this question very carefully, because students confuse. West means north. West means north, it means that in the country XYZ, north direction is called by the name of west, right? So you can say in this question, so west means north, north means south, south means east, and east means west. Now let us read the question. In this country, Mrs. A starts walking towards south for 12 kilometers. So south means east, right? So this is Mrs. A. She walks 12 kilometers towards south, which is east, and then further 10 kilometers towards west. So west means north. So she walks 10 kilometers towards north. Mrs. A then travels a distance of 15 kilometers towards her right. So 15 kilometers towards her right, and again travels 20 kilometers towards her right. So again travels 20 kilometers towards her right. Finally, Mrs. A travels 18 kilometers towards east. So east means west. So she walks 18 kilometers towards west. Now the directions given for Mrs. A movements are according to the words used in XYZ country, right? Now the question is saying, if displacement is defined as the shortest distance between the initial and final points, find Mrs. A displacement. So you have to find the shortest distance between the initial point, this is initial, and this is the final point, right? So now you can see this is 12, this is 10, this is 15. So if you join this line, this becomes 10 and this also becomes 10. And if I join this line, this becomes 15 and this becomes 3. So now you have to find this distance, right, between I and F. And if you see this line, this is also 10. This is also 10 and this is also 10. And if I break this 12, so this is 3 and this is remaining 9. So this is 10, this is 9. Using Pythagoras, you can find IF. So IF, it will be under root of 9 square plus 10 square, which comes out to be under root of 81 plus 100, which is under root of 181. So the correct option is option A, under root 181 kilometer, right? Now moving on to the last question. A river flows west to east and on the way turns left and goes in a semicircle around a hillock and then turns left in a right angle. In which direction is the river finally flowing? So I am not going to tell you the answer to this question. You need to mention the answer to this question in the comment section below. And then afterwards, I will tell you the right answer to this question. So friends, I have tried to explain you this concept of directions in a very simple manner so that you can solve these questions quickly. So if you have liked this video or have learned anything new from this video, then do subscribe to our channel to get more notifications and updates. Work hard, prepare well for your RBI Grade B prelims. All the very best. Have a nice day.